Welcome to the Community Shall Be Restored TV show. I'm your host, Prophet Cedric Banks, along with
Prophetess Dinetta Banks.
We got a great show for you today. We got a dynamic singer, an anointed singer, that's blessing the world. And we thank God for her anointing that sits right next to me on the right. Mary Wynn, anointed gospel singer, recording artist. Mary.
Praise God. I'm really happy to be here. It is a pleasure to be here. I'm just thankful to God for the things that He has done in my life. Most recently, you know, I have had to go through an injury and rupturing my Achilles tendon. I fell, thought I had, you know, an extra step. And it's something how one part of your body can change the quality of your life.
Right, if you, right,
and
right,
it and just
right.
Kind of lets you know, not to take things for granted and to appreciate God for every day that you're able to get up and have the activity of your limbs. Because not being mobile, I had to depend on people. And then when I thought about that in relation to God, I have to depend on God. Like, I'm nothing without Him. And I just thank God for a supportive family, my loving husband and my mom, how they helped me through that time, because it was rough. Because I'm an independent person and I like to, you know, do for myself. But I just thank God, even though I'm still in the process, I thank God for the deliverance that is occurring and that I know that I will be fully restored. So I'm gonna praise Him even more. And with the deeper understanding that God has all power, and without Him, I'm nothing.
Wonderful. You know, well, how long ago, what happened? What type of injury was this, and how long ago was it?
It was at the end of September.
Right.
And I ruptured my Achilles tendon. And right. They told me, you know.
You know, that's a tough injury.
Yes, that's for, exactly what they told me.
For, you know, for the amount of time, the end of September, mm-hmm. and you tore your Achilles. Mm-hmm. And for the end of September, that was just 2 months ago.
Yes.
And you had players in the NBA. I remember Dominic Wilkins tore an Achilles back when he was playing back in the 90s. You know, he was out all year.
Yes.
So that's a tough injury.
Absolutely.
And for you to be making those strides in that short of a time, 2 months, is a miracle.
Amen. But see, you know. Yes, I am thankful. My husband told me the same thing. I can't remember the player that's on the Warriors team, Booby or something, what's his name? But he's been out the whole season and they're talking about trying to get him back. Well, he injured himself last year. And he still has not played for this basketball season. So exactly what you said, it takes time, and that's what they told me. Be patient. Fortunately,
Cousins, but they call him Boogie Cousins.
Boogie
Cousins,
okay.
Right?
Boogie Cousins.
Played
yeah.
for the Warriors. He's a center, 7 feet.
And
center.
That's what I was calling. Right. So I come on, Boogie.
Right.
But I just thank God that He is restoring me, and as you say, it seems like faster than I initially thought.
Well, when you got God in your life and God truly is in your life, He gonna restore you faster than He would the world.
Okay. I receive it.
You see what I'm saying? When it comes down to healing.
Amen. Well, I'm a witness to that. I'm definitely a witness to that. Yes, I just thank God. He is good. I'm more thankful for the little things now that I
right,
took
the little
for granted.
Thing.
Yeah.
You hold more value on the little things.
Absolutely.
And you know, and that's what people got to do. They got to hold more value on the little things. They just like, they got a mindset, well, the little things don't matter. Everybody trying to be a star. Everybody trying to make it to the top. Everybody trying to get a Rolls Royce. Mm-hmm. But you know, with the little things in life, holding value on the little things in life, that's what's precious to your heart right there.
Absolutely.
Life becomes more fulfilling when you hold value on the little things in life. Mm-hmm. Life is more fulfilling.
Yes, because those are the things are the things that really matter.
When right.
You have like family and love
right.
And relationships and people that you know will be there for you when you are down, or be there for you when you can't take care of yourself, and vice versa. You know, they know that you will be there for them. And those are the things that really matter, because the material things you can't take with you. So they fade away. But the things that you'll never forget, like in my dad, I lost my dad 2 years ago, October 2016. And it's really something when you lose a parent, because, you know, I just think about all the things he taught me. So even going through this, he would always say, my maiden name was Matthews. And he would say, you're Matthews, we don't quit. You're Matthews, we don't give up. You trust in God and he'll take you the rest of the way. So I just thank God for the memories and the things that I have to hold on to that he instilled in me. And that's something that
those
I can carry with
those
me
values.
For the rest of my life, yes.
Yes, you know, yeah, you always hold on to the memories. Because the brain never forgets.
Absolutely.
The brain never forgets. And you will always be able to hold on to those memories. And like you said, the little things where people hold in, you know, people don't hold value. People don't really hold value. There is a few though, but they don't hold value like having love for their family.
Absolutely.
I mean, you know, they overlook their family. Take it for granted.
Mm-hmm.
I know you there. But really valuing it.
Absolutely.
Valuing their wife, or valuing their husband, or valuing love, you
yes.
know?
And letting them know that.
Right.
Letting them know that through your actions.
Right.
Not just your words.
Because love is an action word.
Yes.
You know, if you love me, show me.
Amen.
If you love him, show
Amen.
Me. If you love her, show me.
That's true.
Love is an action word.
Yes.
You know, and those things are free. You know, and some people, you know, think about love. Love is beautiful. Think about love. You can go through life, all your life, and you know you're really blessed and fortunate when you can find love, when you can get love in your life, when you can find somebody that truly loves you
yes.
for who you are.
Amen.
Not what you got. Not what you got.
Yeah.
Not who you are. You know, and that's a blessing that Mama seemed like one of your biggest supporters.
Yes.
You know.
Mom is actually the one that started me on my musical journey, because I was born and raised in Saginaw, Michigan.
Okay.
And my neighbor had a piano, and I saw her piano, and I was like, Mom, I wanna learn to play the piano. So my mom, she took me to take piano lessons. I started with classical music, and then in church, I started playing gospel. So I was able to, you know, learn the technical things of it, and then explore my love for gospel, because of course that's my heart. And I just appreciate her, because when I was, you know, a teenager, you know how we get, we think we know everything. And I told my mom, because I saw my friends going out, you know, they were having fun outside, and I'm in the house practicing. And I said, Ma, I think I'm ready to quit piano lessons now. You know, I'm good, because they made me think all along it was what I wanted. So I thought I had the choice to quit. And my mom made it real clear. She said, oh no, you have this gift. God has given you this gift and this talent and all this time and effort we put into it over these years. Oh, we're not quitting. As a matter of fact, go in there and practice right now.
Wow.
And I was crushed.
Right.
I was crushed, but I love her to this day.
Right, because she instilled discipline in you.
Exactly.
She instilled discipline and structure in you.
Exactly.
A lot of homes today, that's why a lot of children don't make it or have no success, because no discipline or structure came from the household.
That's right.
When you got discipline and structure that comes from your household, you go be something.
That's right.
You may not be a great movie star, that may not be your calling,
mm-hmm.
but whatever your calling is, you go reach it, because discipline and structure was laid down to you from here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You got to get it from here.
That's right.
You can't wait for a person to get 30, 40, 50,
it's too late.
And then try to impart discipline in them. It ain't gonna work.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and it charted the course of my life. I didn't know at the time when she made me do that I would eventually go to college, audition, get a full scholarship.
Wow.
Because my parents were, you know, they were at that median income. They said they made too much money for me to get a grant, but they didn't make enough money for me to be able to pay for college outright. So because she didn't allow me to quit and I continued, I auditioned and had a full scholarship to college and didn't have to pay a cent. Now what would have happened if I quit?
What did you take up in college?
Music.
Music?
Yes, vocal music education, and piano was my instrument.
Who would you compare yourself to, or who are you similar to in the gospel arena as far as singing?
Oh, wow.
Well, who would you say you admire? Or?
Okay, I could say admire, because when I was growing up, I loved CeCe Winans, Yolanda Adams. Right. Those are the ones I grew up on.
Right.
Commission, Winans, Clark Sisters. Those were like my loves. I actually cried when Commission broke up. But those are my influences. I wouldn't say I'm traditional. I wouldn't say I'm contemporary. It's kind of like a mix of the two, because I love them both. And they influenced me because I think they took gospel music to another level, as far as it's not one style of gospel that we can do, because you have to... God has people that you are meant to reach.
Right.
God has people that this person is meant to reach. Right. I don't know who it is, but I know I have to do what he calls me to do. So when I do run into those people, I'm able to make a connection with them. So I would say they would be my influences.
Now, you ran with Dorinda, I understand you ran with Dorinda Clark and the Clark Sisters. Well, that's one of our songs that we pray for our praise and worship here every Sunday.
I like living
this kind of life. You know about?
Yes.
Go ahead, sing it.
This kind of life.
I'm living the best of life. Hey, now you talking about my song, huh? You talking about my song, huh? Give me five.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yes, I love
you go hear it. If you go hang, you go and she go hear it.
Yes. She is definitely an example, because she reaches out to the community as well with her Singers and Musicians Conference. She gives local artists an opportunity to be heard and to be recognized, which is something she doesn't have to do. So in that, there's a Singers and Musicians Conference choir, which is great, because in your local church, you know, we're typically running the music department and over everything and, you know, trying to make sure everything is in place. But this gives us an opportunity to sing with other singers and artists that are doing the same things that we're doing. So it's just an opportunity to learn from one another and to grow. And I appreciate her for providing that opportunity.
So she inspired your life?
Absolutely.
Oh, Dorinda
yes.
Clark?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Even before I met her, like I said, that song from back in the day, You Brought the Sunshine.
Yeah.
I played that almost every day for the summer when that song came out. It was like, oh my God, that's what made me really want to do music that could move people, that could inspire people.
You got a song for, I mean, you got a question for Mary Wynn.
So how'd you get your start, Ms. Wynn? How did it all begin? I know you went to college, and from there, how did you get your start when you became acclaimed as a gospel artist?
Yes, that's a great question, because initially, piano. I was happy just being on the piano, behind the scenes. Singing wasn't my first, you know, it wasn't the first thing I thought I was going to do. I thought I was just going to be the musician. I could teach the parts, you know, I could do that, but not a soloist, not a leader. So when I moved to Detroit, I sang in church, and the sound engineer said, have you ever thought about being a solo artist? And I was like, not really, you know, no. And that the seed was planted at that moment. You know, I didn't really think about it before then. And then when he said it to me, I just began to let that mull over my spirit. I tried to run away from it. Because, you know, I said, well, I'm not a talker. I wouldn't know what to say. Lord, you sure this is my calling? You know, but I had to really, you know, because initially when you have a seed planted, that doesn't mean in that moment that you operate in it.
Right, right.
You understand?
That's good.
So
that's
I had to wait.
It's got to germinate.
Exactly.
And get birth.
And grow.
And
I
grow,
had to
right.
Grow. I had
right.
to learn what it meant.
That's good.
To minister in song, in word, and deed, in my life, in my walk. So then when I stand before God's people, it'll be authentic. It'll be real. So it took a few years.
Okay.
It took a few years for me to develop that, for me to learn, for me to study. And then I got into songwriting.
Wow.
So once I cultivated all of that, then I knew I was prepared because I didn't want to give God's people junk or something that wasn't of quality. So in that preparation, then I began to record after a few years of preparing.
Wow.
Yeah.
So have you met any famous people in your life?
Yes, I have.
Who are some of the famous singers you met, or whoever they are, actors, singers, or whoever?
Yes, I've sang in the Gospel Superfest. They actually go all over. Sometimes they have it in Ohio, sometimes in Atlanta,
right.
Baltimore.
I heard about it, the yeah. Gospel Superfest.
So they have
yeah.
many artists participate. Of course, Dr. Cole, Dr. Karen Clark Shear.
Right.
And then they have like the Whispers, R&B artists like
right.
that. James Fortune, Hescott Walker.
Right.
So I did get an opportunity to meet them.
Sing with all of them? Sing with all of them?
At the end, yes, when they do the finale.
Yeah.
Yes, we did sing together. But some of them I actually got a chance to meet and, you know, greet them. Some would give advice. Some may keep moving, but that's okay too.
Right.
But it's just nice to kind of see how things go behind the scenes.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. So you can sing, you're anointed then, because I haven't heard you. My administrator, Teresa, she heard you. She came
okay.
back and told me, you're good.
Yes,
I haven't
sir.
Heard you though.
Yes, sir. Well, I give it my all,
okay.
and I've been doing this for a long time now, and that's what they tell me. But I do, that's my prayer, because the anointing is the only thing that breaks the yoke. So
wow.
I pray that God is hard.
Wow.
Right. So a lot of people, especially Detroit.
Right.
Detroit is music town. You got Motown.
Right.
So it's plenty of people in Detroit who can sing, or across the world, who can sing. So it's not about how well you sing. It's not just about, I'll say it like that, because that's important too, but it's not only about how well you sing. It's what is it that I uniquely bring to the table.
You know, a lot of people can sing, okay?
Yeah.
But they're not anointed.
Exactly.
Being anointed and can sing is two different things. Am I right?
That's right. Yes.
But we gonna let you have the last several minutes of this show, and we gonna turn you loose to bring the anointing.
Yes, sir.
All right, we gonna turn you loose, Mama, husband. We gonna see your anointing. I haven't seen it before. Teresa told me about it. Teresa said, "Prophet, she anointed." So I'm anxious to see.
Yes, sir.
And TV Land anxious to see too. We got 1 million viewers looking at the show.
All right.
So, you got a question?
So, how many songs have you written and how many have you recorded? And how many CDs you have out?
Okay,
purchase,
yes.
How to contact you?
My recent CD is entitled More. I released that 2 years ago, I think. And I'm really just getting back out there promoting it, because after my dad, I just kind of...
Right. That
dealt with family, yeah, and worked with family trying to get everything back together. But now I'm back on the grind. But it's entitled More, and the song I'm going to sing is my single, Great Things. And it's everywhere, Spotify, iTunes, anywhere online. And I appreciate it if you listen to it. Listen to it as much as you can and let it bless you. And the song is called Great Things. And I sing it with a deeper understanding now, as I was saying. But yes, you can reach me online too at marywynn.com. I also have other CDs, 3 other CDs, but my recent one, like I said, More, I recorded it back in the studio, because some of my CDs were recorded live and some were recorded in the studio. So More was a studio recording, and I've written, in all of the CDs, I wrote half of the songs, and then my producer wrote the other half. So I've written about, I say, 25 to 30 songs.
So you write, wow, that many, you written 25 to 30 songs?
Yes, that I've recorded.
Wow.
I've written more than that, you know, that are still in my songbook, you know, but that I've recorded, yes.
Yeah. Acclaimed. Anybody got a question for recording artist, gospel singer Mary Wynn? We gonna go out to the audience now and give you a chance.
What advice do you have for artists in gospel entertainment and you just coming out, just starting? What are some tips that you will give them?
I will start with what I was touching on earlier, to make sure that your life lines up with the ministry. To me, I think that's where the anointing does come from.
Let me say this. You can't get the anointing without integrity.
Yes.
You gotta have integrity to get the anointing.
Yes. When your life lines up with the ministry, what you're saying to God's people, I think that's what will make you stand out as an artist. That would make the connection between you and your members or you and the audience. That's how the connection, I think, is made. When people can feel that it is truly authentic, it is real, like this person is not just giving me lip service. So, and then of course, hone that craft, hone that skill. And I think with those two things combined, and God leading you, I think you'll be unstoppable.
Wow, you'll be unstoppable. You hear that? Unbelievable. Anybody else got a question for gospel recording artist Mary Wynn? Anybody? Belinda?
Hi. I want to know what inspired you to music. I just said.
You know, my mom sang in church. And, you know, I was just marveled. She sang Jesus Can Work It Out. Yeah. Used to tear the church down with that.
Yeah.
And I think that was the first thing that made me say, after, you know, before the seed was planted, like, wow, you know, I just was mesmerized, you know, by my mom and being able to do that. I didn't think at that time that I could, but I think that's what initially inspired me to do that.
Amen.
You know, I want to say this, it's a blessing to when a woman has a career, a singing career, and anointed a woman, anointed and has a singing career, and her husband backs her and holds her arms up.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's a blessing.
Let me clap for that. I always say I know that God loves me because he gave me my husband. I have the most loving and supportive husband that I could ever want. And I told God, I wanted to be happy. Like, I want to be able to go home and be happy. You know what I'm saying? To go home and talk to my husband, tell him about my day. He tells me about his day, you know, and I wanted that. I always wanted peace in my home, love and peace. I didn't care about, you know, getting this and getting that because I knew if I had that,
everything else will come.
Everything else will come.
That's your foundational pieces, love and peace.
That's right. Absolutely. Right. So I'm really thankful for my husband.
I opened up that door with your husband. Opened up that door with you.
Yes,
so
sir.
So we can talk about him, you know, because I really appreciate, you know, seeing husbands back their wives when they have a powerful singing career. We get ready.
Hear the song.
Turn you loose.
Yes, sir.
Like I said, I haven't heard you sing, but my administrator, Teresa, heard you, and she say you're good. But now we all get ready to hear you.
Yes,
so
sir.
So we gonna see if you're anointed.
All right.
I'm just having fun, husband. I'm just playing, husband. Don't beat me up. I play like that.
That's all right.
Okay. I know she anointed. Anytime you wonder with the Dorinda Clark, ooh, you hit that note. We play that song every Sunday. Hit that note again. I like
living. I like living this kind of life. Yeah. I'm living my best life. I like living this kind of life. I'm living the best life. I like that way.
We get ready to turn you loose. Mary Wynn, gospel recording artist. We get ready to turn you loose now.
All right. and put your hands together. If you know that God is doing great things in your life, listen.
So many open doors, gotta pray the morning for. Just drop a blessing, just won't stop.
And I get a witness tomorrow.
Every day, He hears me when I pray. None like nobody greater.
And
you know He keeps. Oh yeah,
great things for me.
He keeps on.
He keeps
doing great
things for me.
Every time I turn around,
He
keeps on
doing great things for me.
Keep blowing my mind.
Jesus is the way.
Always answers me.